When I'm away from you, well, I can't stay still. My thoughts won't move from the way I feel. It happens time and time again, and the circle never ends. When I'm away from you, well, it hurts to say my sense is gone so far away. I'm up all through the night, and I can't tell wrong from right. When I'm away from you, I see great big clouds in the fog and rain, all the lonely crowds, they seem to be so blue.
Welcome back, everybody. And welcome to the first stop on the Butterfield Stagecoach mail route video. We're going to be looking at Walker Station, which was the first stop when the mail stagecoach left Fort Smith and then entered into Indian Territory, as it was known at that time. My goal, if you remember, if you watched the last video, is to make it to the first six stations this summer of 2024. Here is the route with the 12 stops from Fort Smith to what was called Colbert's Ferry on the Red River, just north of Denison, Texas. And again, I'm wanting to make it to these first six stops, the sixth one being about 30 miles south of McAllister. Just for reference, my home base is Fanshawe, Oklahoma, where this clover is. So you can see how close I am to especially the first five stops. So I'm looking forward to it. I'm glad you're interested in this kind of content and that you're going to be watching these videos. I'm going to be coming to you now on my way to Walker Station. I'll be leaving Fort Smith, Arkansas. And I'll tell you more information about that station. Leave comments for me to let me know what you think. And after I come to you from on location, I'll wrap it up here at the home base. Thanks again for watching and humoring me as I bring these videos. I really appreciate it. Let's go now to the road. Hey, all of you on Unique, Oklahoma. I am leaving Fort Smith, Arkansas, the old location of the location of the old military fort set up on the border of Indian Territory, and I am on my way to the first marker of the Butterfield mail route. There is the state line, Oklahoma, yeah! The first station on the Butterfield mail route in Indian Territory, Walker Station. I've got to go about 10 miles. It was located at a spot that is northeast of present-day Spiro. And it was also located at the Choctaw Landing Station for Choctaw Indians coming from the southeast part of the United States. When they entered into Indian Territory, they would enter in at a place called Scullyville. That is where the Walker Station historical marker is. And that's where I'm going to be coming to you next time, or in the next few seconds. But before I come to you from there, let me engage in some appropriate trekking music. Okay, friends, here I am at the location of the first station on the Butterfield mail route through Indian Territory. Now, as you can see, I am on a road that has trees on both sides, creating a nice shady lane both ways. Now, if I pan this way, and you'll see my finger pointing to that direction on the other side of these trees right here. Are some more trees and a field area. And if you go that way, directly by the way a bird flies, you're going to run into the Scullyville National Cemetery. But I am at the location of the marker that marks where the walker station is. And I gotta tell you, you gotta look hard to find it. It needs some work, but as I'm coming to this side of the ditch, that is it behind those bushes. You're going for a close up. Hoping I won't disturb any snakes. And there's a fence there, so I'm going to have to pan in or zoom in. But you can see there, I hope you can see, Butterfield Overland Mail, site of Walker's Station. Here was located a stage stand of the Butterfield Overland Mail Route under Act of Congress. March 3rd, 1857. First mail stage arrived here in September 1858. En route to San Francisco, service continued until the outbreak of the war between the states. Oklahoma Historical Society, 1956, I believe. So they started to put these up around the centennial of the beginning of the Overland Mail route. So that's the location of the first one. I wonder how many people live around here and are not aware that such a marker is right there. Again, just on the other side of that fence. I think I'll go on the website of the Oklahoma Historical Society and recommend that someone come and clear this area. You can do that. You can report markers that are deteriorated and need some work. I think I'll do that. Now, just to make sure I get myself in this picture, here I am on location. Station number one is now under the books. I will come back to you next from the home base and talk a little bit more about this unique part of Oklahoma's history. Thanks again for watching. I appreciate you. Let me know what you think in the comments. And we'll talk with you later. Bye-bye. Hey, as you can see, I'm not at the home base, but I'm at the Scullyville National Cemetery. I forgot that I needed to make a stop here and show you a grave here at the cemetery. So that's where I'll come to you from next. Okay, friends, I am now inside the Scullyville Cemetery, and this is sacred ground for the Choctaw Nation. There's my car way down there at the gate. And this is the second time that I've ever been here. And you've got people buried here that came on the Trail of Tears, as well as significant members of the Choctaw Nation, like this person right here, Colonel Tandy Walker. Now, this is who the first station of the Butterfield Overland Mail Route station in Indian Territory is named for, Walker Station. Named for this gentleman right here. Born October of 1814, and he was born in Mississippi, died in February of 1877. Tandy Walker was at one time chief of the Choctaw Nation, and he took over the old Choctaw Agency building here at Scullyville and made it his residence. He eventually also fought in the Civil War as a Confederate colonel. And I'll put a link to the Oklahoma Historical Society site concerning Mr. Walker and his career. But this is where I wanted to come before I eventually made it home, to show you that this is where the person who the Butterfield Mail Route Station, the first station in Indian Territory, is named for. Now, from where I am at, the marker to the first station is going to be way past those trees. So just kind of give you a perspective of where I am and where the cemetery is in relation to the station. So again, Colonel Walker's grave marker, whom the station was named after. Now I'm coming to you. Now I'm going to next come to you from the home base in Worcester, or more appropriately, Fanshawe, Oklahoma. So I am out from Scullyville National Cemetery. Thanks again for watching. Continue to stay tuned for the conclusion of the video. Bye-bye. All right, back at the home base in Fanshawe. I hope you enjoyed seeing where the station was, Walker Station, and also learning about the man who the station was named after and where he is resting in the Scullyville Cemetery. Let me show one more thing to you and I'll wrap this video up. This first video. So again, we were at Walker Station, probably as the crow flies, 15 miles from Fort Smith, And you know, that would be the Capitol building or the county courthouse in Fort Smith. I think I mentioned in the video that where I was 10 miles from the station. But anyway, and also it is near Spiro, Oklahoma. I did not mention that it's also in close proximity to the Spiro Mounds Archaeological Park. But let me close by showing you what the stagecoaches would have looked like. Now, the first wagon that was used in the initial year or two was what was called the Celebratory Wagon to deliver the mail. And I guess they expanded to where passengers could ride as well. And so the stages took on a more, what we would come to expect in our mind's eye, I think, of a overland stage. So that's it. Well, let me pull that back up. Next week, I'll be going to the second station, which is about 16 miles southwest, and it is about 8 miles west of a little community called Shady Point. If you want to look that up on your map, Shady Point is north of Poteau, right around here, and then you just head west. And that station is called Trahern's Station. Trahern. So until then, I will have a little mini vid this coming Monday. But aside from that mini video, I'll come to you, Lord willing, and if the creek don't rise next week, on the trail to find Trahern's Butterfield Stagecoach Mail Route Station location. Thanks again for watching this. We'll talk with you later. Bye-bye.